These are not your ordinary popsicles. You can't eat them because the flavor's trash. It's literally made up of trash and polluted water collected from hundreds of locations around Taiwan, ranging from rivers to ditches. Take a closer look and you'll find that most of the solid waste in it is in fact plastic.
Plastic has created a tsunami of problems, and it's not just affecting us, but the creatures that we share this world with too.
So how do we turn the tide on plastic? To learn about the global plastic pollution crisis, I went to the ArtScience Museum to meet Josephine, who guided me through Planet of Plastic, an exhibition by National Geographic.
So I'm guessing this net that this poor turtle is stuck in is made of plastic as well?
Yes, so there's this term called ghost fishing, where there's an improper disposal of unwanted fishing net, and it's going to remain there for a really long period of time.
Thankfully, the photographer was able to free the turtle and it managed to live. But not all animals are this lucky.
So this is one of the harmful effects of plastic, when animals think it's food and they ingest it. So this is a young albatross. The reason why the young albatross died is not necessarily because of the plastic, it's because of starvation, because their stomachs are full of plastic.
But Josephine tells me there's more to this than meets the eye. Over time, plastic will degrade into very small pieces, forming microplastics that can not only be found in our oceans, but in the air and even in the fish we eat.
And this particular image here, she's sorting out like thousands of plastic bottles.
Yeah, and it's really sad because all these single-use plastic that we see, the lifespan of it will only be 15 minutes, but they stay forever, like more than 400 years before it decomposes. And this is why it's important to educate ourselves in the fourth R, which is to refuse, like saying no to a single-use plastic bag when you have your own reusable one.
I also learned about how science is providing solutions to this plastic crisis. So I guess it's not all doom and gloom, but I was curious, what about the plastic pollution right here in our country? So I went to meet Tom.
Hey, Amrit, how are you doing?
I'm good.
The co-founder of Seven Clean Seas at a beach cleanup in Sembawang.
We actually get so many of these, you'd be amazed.
Oh, they got another sofa.
Huh?
What? That's insane.
I believe that's a backup of a proton.
A proton, so it must have come from our neighbours.
Tom told me that between November to March, the northeast monsoon brings in waves of trash to the northern shores of our island. No surprises, most of what we picked up was plastic.
So how are you finding the beach cleanup?
To be honest, I'm pretty surprised by the amount of trash that we're seeing here.
I'm happy to hear that you're shocked, and that might sound weird, but if they can come to a beach and genuinely be shocked at how bad it is, hopefully they can reflect on their own plastic consumption when they go back home.
Okay, can I be completely honest with
you? Sure.
Sometimes when you look at the extent of pollution, you kind of wonder, like, does it really help, you know, not using a plastic straw or, you know, refusing single-use plastic?
So it may feel like you're not doing a lot on your own, but you just can't see everybody else that's doing it with you. The most unsustainable thing is actually buying a sustainable product and not using it, because the initial environmental impact is bigger for the sustainable product than the plastic product. So all I say to people is, yeah, go out and get yourself almost like the toolkit, you know? Cutlery, chopsticks, reusable water bottle and a bag, but then use it. Please use it for years. So today, I would love it if we get a weight receipt back and it's 500 kilos, 1,000 kilos, you know, that is a little victory.
Tom, thank you so much for bringing me. Actually, this is my first beach cleanup.
Yeah, well done. Yeah, I'm so happy about that.
Yeah, I've never done a beach cleanup like that. I mean, never done a beach cleanup ever. Okay.
Not going to be your last, right?
No, good. For sure, yeah.
It was actually nice to see people of all ages coming out to clean the beach. It was also great meeting the Seven Clean Seas team and Josephine to learn about plastic pollution and to see its effects firsthand on our island.
But I was overwhelmed by how severe the plastic pollution crisis actually is, especially when you realise that 9 million tonnes of plastic is being dumped into our oceans every year.
But even if you can't relate to these numbers, I think we can all agree that we can do better, not only for ourselves, but for every creature we share this planet with.
And the least that we can do is to refuse single-use plastics whenever we can.
So, inspired by the polluted water Popsicles project, I brought back some trash from the beach and made these as a reminder to focus on the other R, which is to refuse single-use plastics whenever I can.
There's a lot more to see and learn at the Planet of Plastic exhibition by National Geographic, so do check it out at ArtScience Museum now till 28 March this year. And if you'd like to go for a beach cleanup, there's one happening on 20th Feb organised by ArtScience Museum and Seven Clean Seas. We'll add all the links in the descriptions or comments below. Thank you for watching, and remember to reduce, reuse, recycle, and refuse single-use plastic products. Take care!